Hi everyone! Welcome back to integralcalc.com. We're going to be doing another partial derivatives problem today. This one is the function f of xy equals x squared plus xy minus 3y squared plus 4. And they've asked us to compute the partial derivative of f with respect to x at the point 2, 1. So what we're going to be doing is computing the partial derivative of f with respect to x and then plugging in the point 2, 1 to our answer and finding the solution to this problem. So we won't need to compute the partial derivative with respect to y because we're specifically looking for a point in the partial derivative with respect to x. So let's go ahead and compute that partial derivative with respect to x. So when we're taking the partial derivative with respect to x, we always want to hold y as a constant. And what we mean by that is treat it as if it were any other constant like 4 here in our function. So when we're holding y constant, I think the best way to imagine it is to treat it like it is a number. We'll call it 4 here, since that's the example that we used. So taking the partial derivative with respect to x, we go term by term. Since there's no y's involved in this term, this is easy to take the derivative with respect to x, because it's just like taking a normal derivative with just a single variable. So the derivative of x squared is just 2x, right? We know from taking single variable derivatives. Now we run into a problem because we have x and y in one term. Well, if we hold y as a constant and y is 4, then this becomes 4x, right? Where 4 is actually equal to y, but imagine it as 4x. And if we take the derivative of 4x, then the derivative is simply 4, right? You drop the x term and you end up with 4. So if the derivative is 4 and y is standing in for 4, 4 is actually representing y, then you realize that the derivative in this case is actually just y, because the y becomes like a coefficient on the x term here when we treat it as a constant. So the derivative with respect to x of that second term is y. And then here, again, we treat y as a constant. So if y is 4, we'll have 4 squared, which is 16, times 3 is 48. So we'll have minus 48. 48 is just a constant. And when we take the derivative of a constant, it's just 0. Basically, the rule here is, if we're taking the derivative with respect to x, and there are no x's involved in the term that we're dealing with, it's 0, because every other variable is a constant. You're going to end up multiplying everything out. It's going to end up being a constant, and it'll just disappear. So this is going to be 0, and of course this is going to be 0, because there's no variables involved at all. So this ends up being our entire first-order partial derivative with respect to x, 2x plus y. So now that we've computed the first-order partial derivative, we can go ahead and plug in the point 2, 1, plugging in 2 for x and 1 for y. The notation of that, of course, looks like this. Partial derivative of f with respect to x at the point 2, 1 equals 2. We're plugging in 2 for x, so times 2, plus, and we plug in 1 for y. So 2 times 2 is 4, plus 1 is 5. And 5 is our final answer. Hope that helped. See you guys next time. Bye.